straight line. Yellow one, mascara. Friends, many speakers have already addressed on the issue before us. I don't want to repeat again and again to this class of audience the same subject. But one thing I want to tell you. This is a situation where silence shall not be our option. Each one of us, in every possible way, have to raise our voice. That is the reason why I, as a retired chair, is before you to join as one of the persons in your voice against these communal forces. We have constitutional rights, freedom of speech and expression is a fundamental right under the Constitution, guaranteed to every citizen in this country. One thing all of us have remembered, freedom of speech and expression include freedom to dissent, freedom to criticize, freedom to question, freedom to question traditionalism, and freedom to keep silent also. If this is understood, then there is no place for these communal forces to suppress a dissenting voice, to suppress a constructive criticism, to question a traditional game which is inhuman, violent, unhealthy, and destructive. In the last 3 years, we have seen many number of deaths in this regard. The most prominent deaths of Pansare, Dabolkar, Kalburgi, and the latest one is Gauri-Lanki. They might have killed these people, but they must remember that they failed to kill their ideologies that they propagated to the society and to the country. The philosophy that they preach and the ideas for which they live, they are unable to kill and they cannot kill. That is the reason why representing the very same ideology, the very same philosophy, the very same ideas for which they sacrificed their life, we are all assembled in here. Even after 1 month, it is not possible to press the culprits. Culprits in this country, after committing murder after murder, are not brought to book, are not subjected to the process of law. I ask a question to the government, whether they are really protecting the Constitution and constitutional laws and the constitutional right guaranteed to every citizen of this country. Perhaps the only one reason that I could notice is people who do not believe in our Constitution have occupied some of the constitutional courts in this country. We cannot expect a better result from them. We cannot expect a better progress in this matter. It is therefore, I appeal to all of you to unitedly to fight against these communal and fundamental forces. Right to freedom of speech and expression is not a charity given to even us. Every right under the institution constitution is earned through long-term struggle. It is not that easy for the communal forces and the fundamentalists to take away these rights. Whenever there is a threat to these rights, people of this country have risen their voice. They continue to fight relentlessly against these fundamental and communal forces. We continue to do so until we are secure, we are safeguarded, we are protected, Thank you very much.